In this integration respect to t, I want to integrate this with respect to a t. So for that, I can write s pi minus a t, and then d a t. And then, of course, 1 by a. Then if a is positive, then there is no problem. This limit will not change. But if a is negative, then this limit change. Rest of the thing will be same. So, to take care of that, I say 1 of mod a. Now, here 80. It is 80. The coefficient of minus 80 is s by a. So, this becomes s by a. And naturally, the ROC changes. ROC now becomes R1 less than real of S by A. Also get scale S by A. Now let's take convolution property. Let's take convolution property. Suppose we have got a LTI system whose impulse response is ST and input applied to this is XT. XT is any input, and suppose the output is YT. Then we know that YT, output YT, can be obtained by evaluating this. Convolution integration. Now, let's try to find out what is the Laplace transform of yt. Take Laplace transform both sides. Take Laplace transform both sides, then what we get is, let us define Laplace transform of yts, ys. Then Laplace transform of this part. Now, here s tau depends only on tau, so let us integrate the, interchange the order of integration, s tau, then next integral, x t minus tau, e raised power minus s t, and then d tau, of course d t. Now, let's try to evaluate this. You can apply the same thing. So, this is equal to minus infinity to infinity h of tau minus infinity to infinity x t minus tau. Let's generate in the exponent a term s t minus tau. Sorry, t minus tau. So, this you can write as s. Minus tau, so that these two expressions are same, For keeping that, I can write S or T tau dt and d tau. Now, this is e raised power minus s tau. This is independent of t. So, I can factor it out. And what we get here is minus s tau e raised power minus s tau minus infinity to infinity x t minus tau t minus s t minus tau dt and d tau. Now this integral in this bracket, let's consider this x, the function of t minus tau here. Then let's look for the coefficient of t minus tau minus of t minus tau in the exponent of this expression, which is s. So this simplifies to minus infinity to infinity s tau e raised power minus s tau d tau into x of s, and this form defining equation of Laplace transform will conclude. You can conclude that this is hs x of s. So what we get is ys is equal to hs into x of s. We'll see that this convolution integral in time domain has been converted in the S domain into multiplication of two Laplace transform expressions. So multiplying these two Laplace transform is a much simpler process as compared to using this integral. And then we can find yt from here and by taking inverse Laplace transform. We can summarize this. By being that if we apply Laplace transform on this system, then xt becomes x of s, st becomes h of s, and yt becomes y of s. And here ys is obtained as a direct multiplication of this. And from here, if interest is to get yt, you can apply inverse Laplace transform to get yt. Now, suppose we have got an integrator and to this we apply input xt, and it will produce some yt, and yt here will be minus infinity to t x tau d tau. Then the problem is, then what is the Laplace transform of yt? That means, what is the Laplace transform of this integral? Let xt be delta t. Then yt becomes minus infinity to t delta tau d tau. And this we know is ut. If t is greater than 0. That means, and of course, if x is delta tau, then this output is called st, impulse response. That means, the problem now, the equivalent problem is that we have got a system whose impulse response is st, which is given by unit step function. And the input to this is xt, then say output is YT. Then this YT can be written as XT convolve UT. Now let's take Laplace transform both sides. Laplace transform of YT is YS. We have just seen convolution in time domain gets converted into multiplication in Laplace domain. So this becomes X of S and the Laplace transform of UT is 1 by S. So this becomes 1 by S. That means Laplace transform minus infinity 15 x tau d tau becomes 1 by x of s. Now differentiation in S domain. Differentiation in S domain suppose we have got a signal continuous time signal XT, then its Laplace transform is given by this integral and it is defined to be x of s. Now let's differentiate this with respect to s. It's a function of s. We can differentiate this with respect to s. So we get d by ds of x of s. Then this becomes minus infinity infinity xt. And if I differentiate with respect to s, we get minus t here, e raised power minus st dt. Then you can say that minus of t of minus s, x of s, if I compare these two, well, you can argue like this, that the Laplace transform of signal xt is x of s, then Laplace transform of signal txt become minus d by ds x of s, like this. Laplace transform of xt is x of s, then d by ds minus x of then the Laplace transform of t, x t minus d by ds, x of s. You can further differentiate this with respect to s and you can go for a higher multiplication by t. Say, if we differentiate it once more, then we get d by ds minus d by ds of d by ds x of s, then this becomes minus t square x t e raised to the power minus s t dt. You can again multiply by a minus sign and we can say that minus 1 square d by ds of d by ds x of s, this will become the Laplace transform of t square xt e raised to power minus st dt. So like that we can move further. Now, Laplace transform x is equal to be x of s to some ROC, same. Then what is the Laplace transform of dx dy dt x of t? That means first derivative. First derivative. Fine. We have to find out Laplace transform. So we can do it in two ways. Let us try to find out Laplace transform of this directly from defining. Then we have to integrate this by integration by parts. So first function, second function. So first function and integral of dy dt of xt is xt, and this to be related at minus infinity and plus infinity. Minus differential coefficient of first, that means minus s, so you get s and e raised power, then this becomes this expression at both this extreme is 0. X of infinity is also 0, x of minus t is also 0. So this becomes 0, and what we get is s, and this is x of s. So this becomes s x of s. For second derivative it will be s square x of s. For higher derivative like that we can go say dt square xt Laplace transform s square x of s, and of course obviously will get changed because of multiplication by s and s square term respectively. Now let's try to do some problem. Let's try to find out the Laplace transform of Laplace transform of single x t is given by this. Then we apply property of Laplace transform. It becomes very simple. So let's try to find out first the Laplace transform of signal e raised power minus at ut. This we have done yesterday. Laplace transform e u 1 plus s by a, and with ROC real of s greater than minus a. Then if the signal is multiplied by t, then this corresponds to differentiation in frequency domain. Now if we differentiate this, what we get is minus first function, sorry, denominator into differential of numerator, that is 0, and then minus numerator differential with this becomes 1 only upon s plus a whole square. That means this becomes s plus a whole square with no change in ROC. So we have been able to find out the Laplace transform of t into e raised power minus t u t very easily by using property. So the property of Laplace transform must be utilized to solve many of the problems. Now let's try to solve some problem from your book. The problem number 9.1 is really very good. It says that Parisha the following integral is precise the values of real parameter sigma for which which ensure that integral converges. That you can do yourself, it's a good problem. Problem number